The increasing usage of smartphones, high-speed internet, and the digitization of the economy means Ghana needs a talent base with skills to support this infrastructure. Entrepreneur Richard Brand is leading the way, training young people to become world-class software developers to meet the needs of a digital economy. Today on the Joy Business Van, we visit CodeTrain, the coding school he set up to train young people.
Coding is what makes it possible for us to create computer software, apps and websites. It's become a very important skill to acquire as Ghana aims to create a digital economy.
There is something called an MVP. Who has an idea of what an MVP is?
We've come to the Okwa Digital Center, where one of the few coding schools in Ghana is located.
Welcome to CodeTrain.
Hi, Richard. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
I can see school is in session.
Yes, we have students reviewing their projects with their teachers today.
CodeTrain was started 2 years ago by software developer Richard Brandt.
So the idea of CodeTrain started when I was working as a consultant, as a software developer, and it got to a point I needed interns in the company. So I selected a group of students from the universities, and I realized that most of them didn't have the skills, you know, required for them to actually contribute. And but they were good enough, they were smart, they had the theoretical skills, but then you couldn't really use them.
Richard decided to train his interns to become skilled software and app developers, and more young people began to approach him for similar training. It was then he thought he could start a school to extend the opportunity to others. Richard quit his job and started CodeTrain from his home with 16 students. It was a challenging start, he recalls, convincing parents to enroll their children in an institution that was new and teaching something that was not, well, kind of the normal.
With time, we started like showing results. Some of our students started, you know, getting jobs a few months after joining our program. Even though maybe they might have finished university for a while and they didn't get jobs, or they couldn't start careers. So it was at that point that things started turning around by showing results and showing that this really works. Does she need to use even just WhatsApp to market their products? We teach our students mainly mobile and web application development. This is because there is a high demand for mobile and web developers right now globally, and even in Africa, in Ghana, because of the boom in tech. Now everything is, either it's an app or it's a website. So we train our students in those technologies. And our main focus is actually to get them to get to a standard where they can be handpicked by companies and place them in the companies for them to, just start and, get up and running. Our students actually have worked on a lot of apps and solutions to address a lot of problems in society. One of them is an app which is a marketplace for teachers and students. So it allows teachers to find students to offer them private teaching.
That's just one of the many apps developed by his students for effective running of organizations and tackling of some of society's challenges. Richard's vision is that his students can work anywhere in the world, and as he shows me, he's trained quite a number, some of whom are working in international organizations.
We've been able to match about 81% of the students in our MAGIC program into jobs. Some of them have worked for international companies, some of them have worked for local companies, some of them have even started their own businesses. And we've apart from our main program here where we have the school and that we train, and we also go to the universities as well to mainly teach.
Over 400 students admitted so far, and having been adjudged ICT Entrepreneur of the Year 2019, Richard is definitely onto something.
One thing that really motivates me every day is the fact that a student joins our training program, and it's really fun looking at the students maybe in month one, it's at this level, and then 6 months later the same student is you know, talking about building something to help a company, or, and he's building products and he's talking very technical, and you know, you can see their lives improve. It's something that is very, very motivating, even in spite of the fact that there are moments when you are down, but then it helps in you know, motivating and keeping me going.
Train currently operates two branches, one in Accra and the other in Kumasi.
There are so many amazingly creative and talented young Ghanaians, like in even some of the villages and in other parts of the country. We are also getting a lot of traction in neighboring African countries like Nigeria, Liberia, Gambia, and even Senegal and Cameroon. And we are looking for ways to also expand, because our main goal in the next few years will be to make CodeTrain the most reputable technical training school in West Africa.